About 11 years ago, we started Timbre at the substation. That was our first venue. It wasn't so popular in terms of having a music venue, bar, restaurant kind of concept. There were, but not a lot of it. So I think through the years, you know, a lot more concepts have come up. With the success of Timbre, with the success of other brands, you know, people think that, you know, open a bar, have live music. And there's a lot of it. So you're in Club B, you know, Holland B, you know, there's a lot. I think the headwind, I guess, is to the issues that we face is that to always be innovative and to always have fresh content. This is, you know, a beer tastes the same sometimes, you know, different bars, it's the same. So what's the specialty that you bring to the experience of the customers? So on our side, we always try to use technology to make the experience a lot more like a Timbre experience. I mean, the headwinds are really the economy is a mutual challenge. Like I said, I think not to rest on our laurels, be innovative and engage with other people. And I think that's where the content is crucial. Now it's not so much about the infrastructure, it's about the content. You know? I think if you can have world-class content, that helps. Because software, you know, it's not so much hardware. So I think that's the thing that I think we all have to be aware of to improve that. Singaporean customers have become very well traveled. Because with the internet and technology, you know, people know more about things, about new products, new chefs, new dishes, new trends, you know, like for example salted egg. You know, 2 years ago, you know, now you have everywhere is salted egg. So things like that, I think they're very well versed and well informed. So, but more importantly, I think it's about experience. So you can make them, let them enjoy the experience a lot better. Linking to music, linking to arts, linking to different types of activities. That will keep you ahead of the curve. You know, Singapore is not a big country, but there's a lot of entertainment spots. Now, much more than when we first started. So I think to continually be innovative and come out with like you know, new concepts, work with different partners, you know, in terms of doing different kind of events. For example, when we Timbre and Gilman, we had a lot of family-based, kids-based events. So every Saturday we have social barbecue, and that's where we rope in partners to come and do some kids activities. This month we have Jeep coming in, they have remote control cars, and the parents get to test drive the Jeeps, the new Jeeps. So things like that. Really to just keep it interesting for our customers. To continue to engage them, you kind of understand the way they think, mindsets. So for example, when we first started, social media wasn't a big thing. Facebook wasn't a big thing. There were blogs. But that kind of helped us understand that those days the blogs really helped us. So every SMU student had a blog, you know, would post about birthday party or something that they've been through. So now we've got to use social media to kind of engage a wider audience. We use it with video, we do it with different kinds of engagements with partners, brand partners, sponsors, to kind of engage them further. So that's key. You know, to understand how social media works, because that's a very, very important part for business these days. So what we do with that, for example, other than the music school, music academy, which we do workshops, there's one coming up called Game Changers, we're doing with Swapping Nuts, that's our partners from the US, where we actually engage about how to change the game for yourself with your artist, how to do so. So we do other things, and we also mix with dance. We do live music and dance projects too. We have dance classes too in our music school. So, you know, things like that. It's really to open up people's minds. And art is a very powerful way of doing it, you know, because it's almost an emotive way of doing it. So when you have art, and you can say it very simply, you say it. But when you have a dancer and a live band working together, people see it. You don't have to say anything. Say, wow, I didn't imagine that they could dance to this tune, or you know, then the band would say, my goodness, I didn't know that they could dance to my music. So that's the way we try to engage people. And it is the broader purpose. The philosophy is to kind of engage a variety of arts, but to inspire people to think differently. You know what I mean? dude, life is short. You know? I know people always say that it's like a hallmark card, quote, but really, it is for supporters to be a little bit to get involved in music somehow. And I think more people getting involved in art and music will also help the way we think, the way we are creative. So I take it very seriously, actually. Like, more people who like music, more people who like art or film, right? It really opens up their minds, so they understand how people feel too. So that's our philosophy. And it's been consistent since day one. It's just that it took time to grow and expand and do different things.